cliche, 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 cliche. What's that hero love that saves the day? Anyway, cliche, 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 cliche. What about the bad that goes good? Yeah, an innocent love and misunderstood. Yeah, like our glass, toast to cliches in the dark past. Toast to cliches in the dark past.
Girl, girl, perfect woman. Girl, get the blessing from the cops, come running, check the deuces, check the deuces, fuck what you say, boys and blues say,
Yeah, I wrote it, directed, the co-produce.
So you're wearing all the hats?
All the hats.
So say, okay, let's talk about some of those hats you're wearing. So what inspired you to write this particular film?
Well, I mean, being like a student, you know, college student in the Atlanta area and witnessing and being a part of like all the stuff that goes on, like, you know, off of campus, I just had to talk about it. I had to put it out there. I had to, you know, just let everybody know that this is, you know, being a college student, coming with a lot of stuff.
My mama was raised in the era when clean water was only served to the fairer skin.
What attracted me to the project was Keith Lester, who was standing outside when I was walking past, and then he asked me to audition, and he had a really good energy, and I liked him, so I was like, okay, I'll audition. And then after I auditioned, I met Chris, and then I thought that he was really cool, and I kind of liked the way the audition went, and I thought they'd be fun to work with.
Attracted me to this project was a long line of people. It's funny, I was walking to class and I had no clue that the particular audition was that day. I just saw a big line of people and someone screaming from the inside, which is now I know my co-star in the movie, you know what I mean? Like, I heard her singing from outside the room. I was like, okay, that sounds like Lauren, what's going on here? And they said it was an audition for Quick Trip. And I was informed that it was supposed to be the next week. But it was actually that day. I didn't really have much prep at all, but I just kind of just went in there and did what I could. And, you know, I was always attracted to it by the flyer and the information, so it was marketing well.
So it's important to be in the right place at the right time.
Yeah, I feel like if I would have ditched class, I probably would have missed out. I ditched class anyway, but for the audition, you know, it's a totally different thing.
I was walking in the building and I saw a flyer, and it was very subliminal, but the imagery kind of captured me. So I was like, I need to get more information on it. So I went into this information center at the school, and the receptionist was just as discreet as the flyer. But the primary thing he said that truly motivated me to go was like, if you're really serious about acting, you should definitely be there. And I had my headshot and resume in the car, so I was like, oh, know what I'm doing tonight.
Initially, I was walking to class, and I saw the poster outside the Mass Media Arts Building. And it looked interesting. It's not one of the type of films you see being produced on campus nowadays. So I definitely wanted to see if I could be a part of it and enhance the film in any way I could. So.
So you just say the type of film. So how is this different than most of them that you see posted?
Usually you see films about, you know, just typical college things. Students going to class, students studying finals, students partying. But you never see an in-depth look into what could possibly happen if you step outside these college walls. Because I feel like a lot of college students are blinded by these classes and their peers, that they don't actually know what can actually go on in certain relationships, certain lifestyles outside of college.
So this is a real life experience type of film that is beyond the cameras.
I would definitely say it's probably.
Chris Kendrick.
Chris Kendrick, he is extremely passionate about what he does. There are some things that have happened on set where if I was in charge of the project, I would have probably scrapped it. I would have thrown the camera at the wall probably and paid the bill for it. Like, that's how mad I would have got if I was put in this position. But he's really patient. He's willing to work with whatever's there. And I feel like the amount of passion that he has to just say, you know, not to just say, you know what, I don't even, you know what I mean, I'm gonna just start all over. Now he's very driven. It's, you know, no matter how long the film is, whether it's a feature film or if it's just a short film, he's gonna go hard 1,000%. You know what I mean? So it's great. It's great work.
He has really been an inspiration to me personally because of the drive that he has. And you want to be around positive people. And it's like being around him has definitely recharged my battery because there's some things that I was kind of, you know, insecure about as an actor, actress. You have this little, what am I not good enough type things. And he definitely like recharged my battery. And I just know that I learned a lot about patience because he's very patient with us. And that's awesome.
Working with Chris was fun. Chris is very, very patient. And he's very nice, and I enjoyed working with somebody like that. His patience especially, because I didn't really feel, I felt like he always made me comfortable in everything that I was doing. I never felt a lot of pressure. I just felt like everything I was doing was right, and he was very encouraging also.
Was it hard finding the characters that you need, or actors?
Well, actually, you know, we had a little, like a rough start, you know, with the auditions, but, you know, when Lauren Lott, when she walked in, I just knew, I was like, you know, this is the character I saw, this is her. And then when Lee came in, you know, Lee was kind of, you know, he was a little bit of a slower process, but, you know, Lee, he's that character too. And, you know, everybody just came together, it all came together in one big lump, you know, we got Lee.
My character and I, we both share that she is outgoing, and in my opinion, I feel that she is a good girl who wants to be bad, and we're similar in that way, that I'm a good girl, but I don't want to be bad. But her good girl side, I feel like I connect with a lot. And she's really dedicated to her friends, and I feel like that's something that I feel like I'm really dedicated to my friends also. And I feel like she likes to have fun, and she's spontaneous.
Now, you mentioned the word connect. What are those things that you connect to as it relates to the particular character?
What do you mean?
I mean, the character, say, I connect to some of the things about this particular character. Mm-hmm. Can you be more specific about that?
Like,
you connect with her innocence, you connect with her excitement. You know, what do you
mean? Yeah, I definitely connect with how dedicated she is to her friend. She's willing to get in trouble to just help out her friend and to be there for her friend. And I feel like that's something that's kind of dumb, but that's something that I connect with also,
because
I
feel
like I would do that.
I'm portraying the character of Chris, and he's the typical jock, you know, popular guy who has a friend, you know, who is on the nerdier side, and then who has another friend who is more so on the I just want to be in everybody's face side, if you understand what I'm saying. So I'm pretty much the medium in between these two guys.
Okay, so you create a balance, man.
Yeah.
Leander is his full name. He's known as Lee.
So do you see any similarities between Leander and yourself?
No doubt. I think really connection between the friends that I have. There's this particular scene where I'm walking with two of my good friends in the film. And you'll see I'm kind of like the quiet one. I don't really... I speak if I know what I'm talking about. And I'm not really the type to just... You know, especially around my homies, like, I'm kind of like the person that's really reserved and conservative. They'll talk about X amount of topics, and I'll just be there to chime in whenever. I'm never like the leader of that particular conversation, you know.
Tina, okay, do you see any similarities between you and Tina? Do you share any characteristics?
Well, the thing I love about Tina is that we're such opposites. But the one thing I will say we have in common is that we are both risk takers. And of course we're motivated by two totally different things, and she's way more vindictive than I am. But the fact that we are so excited about our vision and what we want, that we truly believe that no matter what happens, this is what I want, it's gonna prosper. So we're both willing to invest and have faith in every decision that we make.
So it sounds like you shake things up in the film, do you?
I am the shaker.
Okay, a part in the film that you said, man, you have got to see this. This is just too funny, too awesome, too exciting. Something about the film. Now, don't give it away now.
I got you.
All right, so go.
I think it has to be All I'm gonna say is, I think it has to be this car scene, okay? Uh-huh. It's a car scene where, I'm gonna just say, the car doesn't necessarily belong to one of the characters.
Okay, don't tell me anymore.
I'm just gonna leave this up to shine lights on some of the talent that we bring to the table. Some of my talents, as well as the producers and everybody on the cast and crew. I think it's something that, like I said, it's a fun film for young adults and adults alike. If you know, I think everybody will enjoy it.
To find your dreams, I want.